1975, the final word in heartburn relief.
I think the number one favorite would have to be the multiple personalities. My name is Jean Randolph.
Nikki Smith.
You are shifting into different personalities 2-3 times a day.
The next favorite was the Old West. I created Ginny, and I made her very different from Vicky.
I had no idea that sitting across from you would be like looking into a mirror.
Yeah, I made her very much a product of her time. She spoke very properly.
What are you doing here?
I am simply looking for an hotel room.
So that the scenes in which I, as Vicky, played with her when I got sucked back into the Old West were not so difficult because we were very separate characters.
I've known you all my life. You are my great-grandmother.
And my third favorite story was the Heaven story.
Just exactly what are you, anyway?
Guardian angel.
Because that was just such a kick, going back and seeing all the characters who had been on the show.
Happy 30th anniversary, One Life to Live.
Previously on One Life to Live.
You've reached a decision about his treatment.
I'll go with your recommendation.
Electroconvulsive therapy.
How do we prove Todd's faking it?
I bet I could get some information.
I really don't feel like going home tonight.
It's up to you.
You're the one who got married.
Are you happy for me?
Yeah. Do you know why she brought us all over for dinner tonight? It was to accept your proposal.
I've always loved the looks of the garden at night.
Yeah. Afraid it was rather neglected while I was gone, but, well, some things thrive, even without direction.
Kind of like kids, huh?
Isn't that why you stopped by at this time? Are you concerned about the children?
Well, you know, no matter how old they get, you never stop being a parent.
Yeah, I figured that out. I have to apologize, because Joey was very rude to you and Lindsay earlier. I'm sorry.
He stopped by the Indigo with a few more choice words about her and me. I gotta tell you, I've never known him to be quite so personal.
Maybe it's just a misguided sense of chivalry.
Well, I guess he could have worse qualities.
On the upside, after you and Lindsay made your announcement, Kevin came back, and we had a very badly needed heart-to-heart.
Oh, good. Good.
Yeah.
That's good.
Yeah.
What about Jessie? I noticed that her smile was a little frozen.
Oh, well, she was trying hard. She'll adjust, Clint. She likes Lindsay.
Well, Lindsay likes her. But then what's not to like about our daughter?
If you're concerned that your marriage is going to traumatize the children, I don't think you need to be.
Oh, I'm not. I'm not. No. I mean, they're basically rock solid, all three of our kids. I must say, though, that Joey kind of set me to wondering. Do you know of any reason why I shouldn't have married Lindsay?
Everything my heart says to you. Every time I pray for you. Everything my heart wants.
What?
I thought, I don't know, I'm seeing things. Where were we?
That show.
What?
Nothing. Nothing. I'm sorry. I guess I'm just feeling a little regressed or something, you know? After crying all over your shoulder because my father eloped with someone he hardly knows. All right, I'm gonna accept your invitation. I can't go home anyway. I always feel better at your place.
Come on, we'll go out this way.
Okay. Hey. Sit here. I'm kind of wondering when you're gonna, you know, cut loose.
With what?
Well, for starters, maybe how you feel about your mother's instant marriage. I mean, you haven't said a word.
Well, he's rich, he's decent, he seems to like her. What's to react?
Do you have any feelings on the subject?
What's the point?
Well, the point is, I guess, is you're gonna have, like, you know, some step-siblings and a step-family. I mean, there's gonna be a lot of change in your life.
So?
So. Look, Will, no matter how incomprehensible to you my relationship with your mother may have been, the fact is that at least we were predictable, you know?
You know, Dad, it's starting to sound like this bothers you more than me.
No, not really.
Why don't you cut the shrink speak and tell me about the local attractions?
Oh, Sam.
Hey.
So glad you're here.
Hi.
I'm starting to panic about Todd and the shock treatment.
Really? Excuse me, Taya. Will Rappaport? Taya Manning? Taya? Will?
Oh, your son. Oh, mm-hmm. Of course. Well, I'm sorry to interrupt.
No, it's no problem. So, old Boomer's got you going again, huh, Pop?
I need to go in and see Todd.
It's after hours, Kevin. What for?
Look, my mother and I have been going at each other's throats over this whole thing. We had a long talk about him. I think I'm beginning to understand how and why she loves him, so I would just like to go in and see him, talk to him on her behalf. Can you let me in?
Work, huh? So original, so moving.
Stop running yourself down. You're a little stuck, that's all. It happens to all creative people.
Creative? Oh yeah, that's creative, all right. We're halfway through the summer, Jess, and I've got zip. In the fall, you're going to college, to New York.
And you're coming with me, only to art school.
Not if I don't get that scholarship. I mean, what if I don't have the guts? Skills, the inspiration, or whatever it takes to get there.
You do. Yeah. But do you want a plan B? Okay. I go to Landview U for my freshman year, and you reapply for the scholarship the next year.
Great.
It might be. You know, my mom might need me around. She says she's okay with this whole dad getting married thing, but I know her a lot better than that.
Your mom is as strong as mine. She'll get through this fine. But she'll never forgive me if I kept you from going to a fancy Ivy League school.
Are you kidding? She would love to have her baby home one more year.
And it'd be lousy for you, too. Because you don't want to be treated like a baby anymore. And I don't want to keep treating you like one.
You don't. Trust me. You're just patient and caring.
Angel Square Fire Department. They test every night.
I knew it was a test.
You can still flunk it.
I can't.
Well, Todd is not in great shape these days.
I'm sorry to take up time between you and your son.
No. It's fine. I mean, I figure I owe Todd Manning a lot. He got my dad to practice being a dad. I hope I get to meet him one day.
Well, I hope I get to meet him again, given his current condition. I told Dr. Lang to go ahead with the ECT, but I am having second thoughts.
ECT, that's where they zap you, right? My friend of mine at school, his mom had it. They were afraid she'd be toast, but it turned out fine.
Well, that's good to hear. It's terrifying to be the one responsible for giving the go-ahead, and I have so many questions, Sam.
Have you asked Dr. Lang? Have you talked to him about your questions?
I'd be calling him every 10 minutes, and we just spoke for an hour. I think what scares me the most is what if Todd wakes up and he's not Todd anymore?
Well, what scares me the most, Taya, is if Todd stays the way he is. Look, I'll be there tomorrow morning, all right, for the therapy. And don't worry, I think everything will be okay, and we'll have Todd back in no time.
Thanks, Sam.
Sure.
Thank you.
All righty.
Enjoy Landview, Will.
Thanks.
Yes.
Toast? Let me ask you one thing.
What?
My mom has said 100 times that Todd Manning is a lunatic. Now, what is it about this guy that makes you feel you have to constantly watch over him?
Well, it's so complicated. I can't go into it now. I can't go into it here. But let me just say that I feel a sense of obligation for Todd. I always have. And look, I've known him since he was a kid. Fact is, no matter how old he gets, I still think of him as that kid.
Yeah. Yeah, you always did. Like he was a kid of yours.
You're resentful? You've never been so upfront about it before? I don't know. What's going on?
Maybe I never figured it out before. I mean, moms always complain that you got way too deep into your cases. Todd's just one more rescue number for you, isn't he?
Wait a minute. You're really oversimplifying things there, I'll tell you.
Is that why you and Mom broke up in the first place? Your whole rescue thing?
So what happened, Todd? Huh? What'd you do, hear us out in the hallway and decide you're gonna take us for a little ride?
It doesn't matter anyway. I'll have to stop faking by tomorrow.
Why? What's tomorrow?
He's scheduled for ECT. Electroconvulsive therapy, otherwise known as shock treatment, Todd. You want to say something to him? Go ahead. I'm not going to stop you.
Thanks. Oh, boy. Well, you heard the man. I mean, you're going to have to come around by tomorrow. Otherwise, unless you want to just drop the whole act right now, then you can make a full recovery tonight. You'd do my mother a really big favor in the process. You see, because, Dad went off and married Sam Rappaport's ex-wife. What does that mean to you? Well, maybe nothing, but it gives you the opportunity to lift my mother's spirits, and she's certainly done that for you many times in the past, hasn't she? And God only knows. It makes no sense at all, but she loves you. As a matter of fact, when the chips are down, she's willing to put you ahead of everybody else in this family. Everyone. Just to defend you, protect you, uphold your innocence. So, really, I don't think she could want anything more than just a phone call from you at this point, Todd. You know, make her feel better and all. So what do you say? What do you say? Come on, Todd. Give your big sis a call.
Do I know of any reason why you shouldn't marry Lindsay?
Yeah.
No, I sure don't, no. I guess I was a little bit startled by the suddenness of your marriage, that's all. But when you know, right? Some people take a little longer to know. And some people know right away.
Well, I was kind of a little surprised myself.
I think it's wonderful that you found someone. I really do. She's lovely, and you deserve to be happy.
So do you.
I just hope she knows and appreciates how lucky she is to have found such a wonderful partner. I would have said that earlier, but I guess it would have been in poor taste.
I imagine Lindsay will figure out who taught me to be a half-decent husband.
Have you met her children?
Yeah, I met the boy. He's, his name's Will, and he's 18 and kind of a handful.
Yeah, well, he's 18. Our boys were a handful when they were 18, weren't they?
Well, I think they still are, in their way. You know, I gotta say, you kind of caught me by surprise yourself. I mean, promoting Kevin the way you did. Not that I'm not pleased about it, because I am. But we've most always consulted on the big ones.
Yeah, and, oh, boy, was I going to talk to you about this. I was. But then when I got back from my cruise, you were in Las Vegas.
Bad timing, I guess.
Yeah. Really bad timing.
Vicky, look, let's stop tiptoeing around this and bring it right out in front and deal with it. Now, before you left, I proposed to you, and you turned me down. Now, you didn't say maybe, you said no.
That's right, I did.
Yeah, well, Joey's got this wild idea that, well, that when you came back and you called the family together, that you were going to turn around and accept me. Is there any truth to that?
Well, if you were asking, did over-involvement in my business and everything else kind of contribute to the demise of my marriage, the fact is, yeah, I mean, it did. But I get another color here. How many times do I have to tell you that my marriage falling apart had absolutely nothing to do with you and Jenny? Nothing at all.
Nah, I got enough of the party line when I was 13, Dad.
Hey, wait a minute. That's not the party line. That's the truth. Are you not buying it?
Let's just say that I had my doubts about... Son, your mother and I have grown in two different directions.
Well, that does sound a little stiff, but the fact is, it was true.
So, am I grown up enough to hear the rest?
And listen to me. I don't regret for a moment marrying your mother. Not a moment. Especially because I got the two best kids in the world out of the deal, all right? I love you and Jenny. I don't regret that. If I regret anything at all, pal, it's that the last 4 years, I didn't get to come home to you guys.
And so, since we're into the truth and nothing but then here, what can you tell me about this hot blonde bimbo that Mom mentioned?
She's not a bimbo. She's hot. She's blonde. Her name is Blair Kramer. And the fact is she had a prior emotional commitment, and I chose not to get involved. I didn't want to put myself in the middle.
Yeah, I know the feeling.
Hey, couldn't give us heads up about your ex and my dad?
I didn't get a heads up. There was nothing to tell you. I'm sorry. I was just as surprised as you were.
Right.
Well, I guess you're Buchanan. And I guess that makes us related.
Hi, I'm Jessica Buchanan. And this is my brother, Joey. Why don't we welcome him to the family, huh?
I would do dialing for you, you know. And all you really have to do is talk to her. You don't even have to tell her that you were faking it. You could just say, hey, I'm back. You know what? I have an idea, Con. Tell her that you made a miraculous recovery because you felt her pulling for you. That would really make her feel good. This just isn't on your list of priorities, is it? Your sister is in agony, and you got the power to change it. And you're not gonna do it, are you?
Nope. You're not.
Did I'm looking for a piece of heart in this guy. And I'm pleading for him on behalf of my mother, and he just sits there and laughs at us.
He has amazing control.
Yeah. What I'd like to do to him is I'd like to wheel him out of here right now and take him down to that shock room and zap him out of his sham. And then I could present him to my mother. And it's all quivering. So here you go, Mom. Here's the brother that you believe in.
But you wouldn't do that because you don't want your mother to hurt any more than she already does.
I don't want her to get sucked into this any more than she already is. I'm not going to let him do it.
Okay. I think I have an idea.
You have one new message. I will play one new message.
Taya?
Some stunner, huh? Your dad and my mom, or were you not as blown away as your brother?
Oh, no. I was pretty surprised, weren't you?
Yeah, well, when you have a mom like mine, you're pretty much ready for anything.
Obviously.
Sorry?
Weren't you supposed to get here a lot sooner? I mean, your mom threw you a big hello party, but you never showed. We waited.
Yeah, it's funny, actually. If I had, if I'd come back from Vegas when I was supposed to, none of this would have happened.
How do you figure?
Well, your dad and my mom came out there to find me, and there wasn't enough seats on the plane, so they sent me back alone. Last I knew, they were headed to Wayne Newton, but my plane ended up getting stuck in Dallas, and by the time I got here, they had already landed and been hitched. Go figure.
Excuse me, wait a minute. Are you saying that your mom's marriage is like your fault?
Who said anything about fault? I mean, Mom looked pretty happy to me.
Yeah, so did Dad.
Excuse us, all right? I've got to get my sister home here.
Do you have a curfew?
No, no curfew. Just manners. Out of respect for our mother. You guys have a good night.
Is it just me, or does my new stepbrother hate my guts?
Well, let's just say I think it takes, some people longer than others to, like, warm up to. Don't worry about it. But speaking of new people, though, who was that rather beautiful woman I saw you get off the plane with yesterday?
Back off, Dad.
No.
Hey, wait. Actually, though, it's funny you should mention that. Do you believe in love at first sight?
To me that you want to get involved like this, Barbara, but I just think that...
Look, I'm just glad that I'm here. And with David in for testing, I've got a lot of spare time.
Yeah, but you've already done enough. I mean, just by listening.
Anyway, I should go. I gotta see Cassie at home. She knows I'm here. She's gonna be really angry.
Oh, come on. Cassie's gotta know that it means more than that. Maybe she doesn't. Maybe because she didn't see you at the lodge holding a gun against Todd, trying to protect your family. And me.
Only Todd knows you were always going to pull the trigger on him. So now, I think no matter what I say or do...
You haven't heard my idea.
Okay, then I better listen. Go ahead.
Okay. I've done a lot of research into catatonia, and I've seen Todd enough to know that he's very dependent on keeping himself tightly controlled. So what if we give him, or threaten to give him, a drug that will make him lose that control?
What are you saying? We scare him into coming around? I kind of like it. I kind of like that. I love it. But wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. Why are you so willing to get involved like this?
Kevin, you know, you weren't the only one in that wine cellar. It changed me. So if you're willing and you're willing to get Drew to help make this happen, then I'm willing to.
What did Joey say that would make you... what made him think that I was going to accept your proposal?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe he was just hoping real hard that we were going to get back together.
Yeah, that could be. Boy, that proposal, that seems eons ago.
A lot can happen in a short time. You know, I think I owe you an apology.
Why? I wish you well, Clint. I really do.
No, not for that. I mean, for being pushy when I should have been patient.
God, you were eminently patient.
Well, not that night when I proposed. I think I kind of lost my head and gave you an ultimatum. You know, marry me or else.
Things happen for a reason.
I just couldn't imagine anyone being a more perfect partner for me than you. And when you let go for good...
Your imagination took flight.
Yeah, I'll get that.
No. No. No, it's okay. I can manage everything. I can't expect any help in the garden anymore.
That Will guy seems pretty arrogant, doesn't he?
Seemed all right to me. Come on, Joey, we don't even know him.
It seems like you might want to.
Well, yeah, I mean, he is our stepbrother. Maybe we should. No, it's not like that. I'm with Christian, you know that. I mean, really, with Christian.
Oh, no, I didn't know that. Did you really want me to?
No, it's not that way. I mean, not yet, anyway. I don't know, it's more than that. I mean, it's that, too, but... Why is love so confusing?
You're asking me? Okay, what happened? You guys get in a fight?
No. I don't know. Things with Chris are just different.
Different good or bad?
Tonight with Chris, it was deeper than anything. You know, it was almost like I was drowning or something. But not in a bad way. Isn't that weird? I mean, it's like if you were drowning, where the struggling would stop. You just give yourself over.
But you didn't.
No. The fire department was still off. And then I surfaced, and I could breathe again.
And?
And I made up an excuse and got out of there. I didn't want him to know what I was feeling. Whatever that means.
I know that feeling. It's really nothing to be scared of. I mean, it's just that you've crossed over.
From what to what?
From high school puppy love to grown-up love, Jess. And yeah, it's confusing, but like I said, there's nothing to be afraid of, especially with Chris. He's a great guy. And I believe that he loves you like a grown-up.
So do you think I should let him know what I'm feeling?
Would that be for you or him?
Well, I know it would make him feel better. No. Yeah. I should do it. I'm going to let him know right now.
No, you're not. You're not going to go back over there tonight.
Well, who are you trying to be now? Dad?
Oh, Sam.
You knew me right away. Think I'm insulted.
No. You look different.
I hope so.
But your eyes. That little girl is still in there.
Oh, you don't look any different at all. Bigger, sure, and more muscles, but same face. Same pouty mouth.
Yeah?
Yeah. And you talk just the way your letters sound. They raised some eyebrows in my building. Roseanne's got a boyfriend. Roseanne's got a boyfriend. Nobody believed me that a cousin would write so much.
I just answered the ones I got.
Except the last ones. So, your own place. How grown up we are. Don't tell me you still haven't got a model. How hard can that be?
I told you, hard.
You always were so particular about your art. You remember when you made that collage from Antonio's bottle cap collection and all those postcards that your grandmother saved? It's a wonder that you lived.
Mommy made me give him to Abuelita for Christmas. And I had to buy Tonio's sodas for a month.
So, this is what you see every day. Man, it's so different from...
Don't move!
Huh?
Do not move.
Oh, yeah, I believe in love at first sight. I mean, I believe it exists. Come on, let me see this thing here. Whoa. She's very beautiful.
She's more than that.
Do you know why she might cut whoever that is out of that picture there?
Well, no, she's pretty heavy into symbolism. I mean, she had a voodoo doll with her.
Voodoo doll? Great. Who was the guy, do you know?
Forget the guy. Who's this girl?
Look, pal, are you sure you want to pursue this? I mean, I don't know, it looks like it could be trouble.
So? I mean, you didn't raise me to quake at danger.
I hope I didn't raise a damn fool either.
Look, I'm saying that I can take care of myself.
Okay, that's fine. It's just I want you to think about this. You know, ex-boyfriend, voodoo, all that kind of...
Dad, do me a favor and stifle the dad talk, okay? I mean, people fall in love and get in trouble all the time. It doesn't stop them.
You know something? I know that you're just gonna snap right out of it when they go to shock you tomorrow. But I got a real problem with that. Because I won't be here. And I need to be here to see it. So I've enlisted the help of a good friend, Nurse Barbara. She's got something real special for you. Sodium pentothal. It's great stuff. It pretty much just wipes out all your inhibitions. Of course, if you really are catatonic, you know, and you're as far gone as these doctors around here seem to think you are, well, then it just wouldn't work at all. But if you're faking, they make you feel so good that you wouldn't even worry about the fact that you're letting the cat out of the bag. And then me and Drew and Barbara, we'd all have a good laugh. Oh, and if you're thinking, because I wasn't able to pull the trigger on you up at the lodge, that I won't be able to pull this trigger, well, you got another thing coming. I know what you're thinking. You're probably saying, well, gee, you know, he's Kevin, he's Vicky's son, he's got a little decency. But when it comes to you, I'm really not a nice guy at all, Todd. Not at all.
And by the way, if you got an idea in your head that somebody around here might try to stop this, you might really want to consider if it's worth it for you to take that chance.
Sit still.
What am I, a cocker spaniel?
No, you don't have spaniel eyes. There's fire in them. I remember that. I also remember you couldn't stay still. I remember that look, too. The madder or the gladder you got, even though more fire in them. Look, Roseanne, if you don't want to do this, you don't have to.
No, it's no problem. I never do anything that I don't want to do.
I remember that.
No, I'm not trying to be like Dad, and that's a crummy thing for you to say. Especially being that I'm really not feeling too hot about Dad right now anyway. Especially his bride.
Well, I'm not going to go over to Christian's tonight anyway.
Good.
Not because you told me not to.
Oh, God forbid.
But because every time I think about him, I just get this nervous feeling. Maybe if I stick around, somebody will tell me what's going on. Like, is Dad really in love with Lindsay? And what does Mom think about it?
Hey.
Hey, Dad. What are you doing here? Didn't you just get married?
Yeah. And I was just on my way out.
Yeah, well, Dad and I had some just unfinished business.
Talk to you later. We'll get together. Joey. Good night, Becky.
Good night. Come on. I cut this by mistake in the garden. I couldn't see in the dark that it was still alive.
You know, it's a shame, really, because you're not selling me. You can see and you can hear. You're lying there looking out, thinking you can fool everybody. Like my mom. But she can't fool me. You don't ever fool me. Okay, Barbara, do the honors.
Visiting hours are over a long time ago.
He called me. He needs me.
That's not possible.
No, I heard him on my voicemail. He needed help.
Look, there has been no change in his condition. Now, you should go back home. You're only going to be disappointed.
I want to see my husband.
Taya, no. I'm sorry. I can't let you back in there.
God!
Taya.
Stay tuned for scenes from the next One Life to Live.